YouTube. What's going on? It's Richard, founder of Short Term Rental University and Airbnb Superhost. And today's video is absolutely insane. I can't believe I'm filming this. I had no intention or desire to do what I'm about to talk about, but I did it. And I feel like I got fortunate. I was very fortunate because I didn't know what I was getting myself into. So in a nutshell, you see that big mountain behind me, and there's like this darker striation. Maybe we can zoom in on that. That looks like a elephant trunk. That right there is Mount Moran. Right now we're sitting at about 6,500 feet. This is Lee Lake, and then that's Mount Moran. And just a couple of days ago, I went and summited Mount Moran. And as you can see, it's basically a rock face. So I thought I was going on a hike. It turned out I was going on a climb. And I had no idea that hiking and climbing were entirely different sports and activities. But I'd never done anything like this before. I went out for a one-day training session with my man Kai, showed me the very basics about rope and climbing, and I thought in order to summit Mount Moran, there would be a couple of technical sections where that would come in handy. What I was ignorant about, and I didn't ask the right questions, and that's where I'm fortunate, because had I asked the right questions, I would never have done this. And this was a once-in-a-lifetime experience. I'm so glad I did it. I proved to myself physically and mostly mentally that I can accomplish anything, and that I can actually show up, and I can suspend fear and disbelief and be reasonably like successful in any endeavor, in any environment, with the proper guidance and leadership, coaching and safety. And I have a fear of heights, so for me to climb that thing was crazy. There were sections where I was what's called exposed, where I'm hanging, like wedged onto the rock, hands, toe foot, you know, toe hold, and I'm stuck on this rock and there's nothing beneath me. That's what's called exposed. It's also an area of extreme consequences. If you fatigue, if you make a careless mistake, if your leader isn't tying the ropes properly, I mean, there's grave consequences. This isn't an area where you have a do-over or a, let me try again. So let me give you the very basic mechanics of what I actually did, and then I wanna share with you the lessons that I learned that are so helpful for me and hopefully will inspire you. So the very first thing I want to say is it was a two-day affair. We left the first day at 11 o'clock. We took a canoe on Lee Lake here, which is directly behind me. Maybe you see some people passing by. That was about 10 or 15 minutes. And then we actually had to carry the canoe. It's called Portage. We carried the canoe over this little island onto Lee Lake, or maybe this is Lee Lake and that's String Lake. Either way, we carried the canoe over the land for about another 15 or 20 minutes. It's really heavy. It's got three packs and a stove and all the gear that we need and all the food that we need and water. We're carrying this canoe over to this next lake, and then we're on that lake for maybe a good 45 minutes or so until we got to the base of Mount Moran. We ditched the canoe into the woods. It's nice and safe. We're in Teton National Park. There's not a lot of visitors here. And then we put our packs on and we spent the next, call it hour and a half or 2 hours, doing what I would call a boulder scramble up the base of Moran to our base camp where we set our tent. So at 3 o'clock the next morning, we start to prepare ourselves for the day, had a quick bite to eat. And by 4 o'clock in the morning, we've got our headlamps on and we're climbing in the dark. It's pitch black. It's not going to get daylight for another, call it 2 hours or so. And so the spotlight is just focused directly in front of us. And in many ways, that was a good thing because I couldn't see what was around me. I couldn't see the heights. I couldn't see any of the technical challenge. It was literally just one step at a time. And like I said, that's a really good approach. When you're doing something that you're uncomfortable with, instead of thinking about the big picture and instead of thinking around the surroundings and instead of being focused and consumed with fear, I was just focused on one step at a time. And my flashlight, my headlamp, allowed me to do just that. And so I took one step at a time. And before I knew it, 2 hours later, it was sunrise, and that was spectacular. I was high up in there during sunrise, and it was absolutely glorious and magnificent, and I felt so full of life and energy. And then I also saw the daylight, and it was kind of scary. It was like, oh my gosh, this is insane. What am I doing here? But I suspended all of that because at daylight, we faced our very first technical challenge, which is called Drizzle Puss. And it's this gnarly, like tooth-shaped rock. We had to go up over it, literally straddle it, and then come down the other side. When you're climbing up that and then going over it, and then specifically when you're going down it, you're fully exposed. There's nothing beneath you. So my very first introduction to rope climbing was in the most exposed portion and technical portion of this entire summit, and it was absolutely insane. And then I looked up at Mount Moran, and I couldn't believe that we were gonna just climb that rock face. I mean, that's 12,700 feet, so we're at about 6,500. We were doing about 6,000 vertical feet over 2 days. Incredibly steep, incredibly challenging, both physically and mentally, and now the hike was about to begin at about, call it 6:30 in the morning, up Mount Moran. It took us about 4.5 hours of technical rock climbing, Kai showing us the steps, where we were going in the route, and it's a miracle, right? He could read that thing like you and I read a highway. So long story short, we summited, we got up there about 4 hours later, spent a little bit of time up there, incredible views, you're looking out over the entire valley, it was absolutely magnificent. And then we had to start the down climb. I was really bummed to hear that what we just went up, we had to literally go down, and that was really challenging. I was already physically exhausted. Going down is much scarier because you're less secure than going up. And that took us an equal amount of time, about 4.5 hours to get down to the bottom, just to get back to where our tent was. At that point, we had a little bit of a lunch, a little bit of a meal, some water, started breaking down the tent, and then we had to do the rock scramble down for the next 2 hours. And at that point, fatigue was setting in. I was losing focus and concentration, yet I'm on these big boulders and I can't slip and I can't fall and I don't want to roll my ankle. I didn't want to injure myself like in the last, mile of this event. This was the most scary, life-threatening, insane experience of my entire life. I didn't know what I was getting into, and that's the good fortune because I don't think I would have done it. Had I known what I know today, I wouldn't have done it. And I'm not recommending any of you do anything this dangerous or life-threatening, right? Let's be really clear. This isn't a video that's encouraging you to take those kind of risks. If you're qualified, if you're with an expert guide, if it's within something that you want to do, sure, go for it. But this video is not encouraging anybody to take this kind of risk. So let's just be clear about that. And so when we finally got back down, it must have been about 6 o'clock or so, and then we had to canoe across one lake, portage and carry the canoe over the island, back to the second lake, which is directly behind me, and we basically got back to the Exum guides at about 8 p.m., and our day started at 3 a.m., and it was incredibly physical, it was incredibly mentally challenging and rewarding, and it was just an insane day that I could never imagine I would ever do in a million years, right? Like, this was not something I wanted to do with a fear of heights, and I always thought people that were climbing summits like that with ropes had a screw loose or something like that. It just wasn't my thing, and yet here I was, clinging to the side of that rock with dear life for everything I had, every ounce of will and muscle and energy and excitement and peak state just to survive, right? It was like survival instinct. And it was amazing and it was incredible. I suspended all my fear until I got home that night. When I got home that night and I was exhausted and I was safe and I was secure and I was breathing and I got really scared. Like, that's when it first sank in, what I just did and what risks I just took and how grateful I am for my life and my body and my health and my loved ones and my family and my girlfriend. It was like, that's when it sank in and I couldn't believe what I had done. But for the 2 days prior, I didn't have a chance to think about that. I had to show up and I had to perform. So let's turn to the lessons. And the very first one is, if you're going to go way outside your comfort zone, make sure that you've got experts with you or training or the right equipment. Make sure that you're safe. I mean, safety is critically important, and I was very safe. In fact, I told my guide, Kai, that in the riskiest environment I've ever been in the riskiest sport I've ever done, and the craziest thing, most unimaginable thing I've ever done, thanks to his leadership, I felt very secure and comfortable and confident, and I was able to relax and perform. So the very first thing is make sure you surround yourself with mentors, coaches, leaders, experts, guides that can help you get outside your comfort zone in a safe way. The second thing I realized was that I can do anything. Even though I had never done this before, I stepped up physically, I stepped up mentally, I went way outside my comfort zone. I did things that I never even dreamt I would ever want to do, and yet there I was actually performing them. And so the lesson there is, we are stronger and more capable and more able than we ourselves think. And if you've ever had your back up against the wall where you absolutely had to perform, you do it. You've done it, you'll do it again. And I filmed a Facebook Live about it. Tony Robbins called it burning the boats, which is basically like, I'm gonna take a boat over to that mountain and then I'm gonna burn the boat and I have no choice but to go up it. And that's basically what I did. I had no choice. There was no returning. There was no exit strategy. There was no plan B. The only plan that worked was plan A, and that was to go up and then right back down and then up Drizzlepuss again and down Drizzlepuss. And that's where I got really, really crazy. When I finally got off Mount Moran and I got to the base of Drizzlepuss, I was so happy and relieved and I was alive and I wasn't injured and I was feeling great. And then I learned that we had to go back up Drizzlepuss and then back down Drizzlepuss. And that was some of the most technical sections again of the entire climb. And I just felt defeated and deflated and I was just like, I can't anymore. But you know what? I could, and I did. And that was a second lesson. I just did the most crazy thing I've ever done, and now I have to do more of it. And I just couldn't believe it. And then when we finally got down, my body was now tired and exhausted, and I still had to perform mentally. I had to make sure that my muscles weren't sloppy and that I didn't roll an ankle. And so when you think you've given all, and you think you have no more left in the tank, and you think you're running on empty, maybe you're on fumes, you still have more. You still have more. I had more. I managed to perform. I was really slow on the way down. I was super careful. I really didn't want to injure myself. And so I didn't, and it took longer. But overall, the main message is we all have comfort zones. We all recognize that those are limiting, right? Like we should expand our comfort zone. So if you're comfortable here, go here. You don't have to do what I did, go here to here, right, and beyond, but just expand it a little bit and take those risks, whether it's a business risk, a relationship risk, a short-term rental risk, a physical risk. You gotta push the bounds a little bit and test yourself. And in that testing, you'll learn more about yourself than you knew was possible. You'll start to gain confidence. You'll know that you can do things you couldn't do before, which will enable you to take slightly bigger risks and more risks and grow yourself even further. And as you grow yourself and your abilities even further and your confidence is increasing and you're taking more risks, you're growing your opportunity set for your loved ones, for your family, for your legacy, for your estate. But if you don't take that very first step, right? If I didn't just say yes to my friend Dakin, who invited me, not knowing what I was getting into, I wouldn't have ever done that. But I just said yes, and that was a year ago, and then the day showed up, and I was like, okay, let's go, it's go time. And as a consequence now, I know 100% in my body that I am stronger than I thought I was. I know mentally, I'm more capable than I thought I was. And I also no longer have a fear of heights. You see, I just extinguished my fear of heights by dangling from that mountain back there for hours. And what I realized was that heights aren't what I'm scared of. What I'm scared of are the consequences that heights may bring about, i.e. falling. But if you don't fall, there's nothing wrong with heights, right? So I no longer have a fear of heights. I still remain fearful of the consequences that have come with falling or heights, but I'm also fearful of being trapped in a fire, for instance. Yet that doesn't limit me because I don't run into fires every day. In fact, I just walked on fire at Tony Robbins Unleash the Power Within. So like this guy, this body, this mind, doing all sorts of things I've never done before, which is leading me to have strength, conviction, motivation, ambition, desire, growing, stretching, motivating myself, doing more, doing it faster, doing it better. And I just have to be careful that I don't fatigue or do something stupid, right? But I'm really enjoying that growing and that stretching. And I hope this video is encouraging you to think about a risk that you might take. Maybe you want to invest in your second short-term rental and you were fearful. How can you overcome that? Maybe you want to get started and it's your first one, but you're worried about making the mortgage payment or the payment to your landlord. How can you get started? Maybe you're worried about ending a relationship or starting a relationship. How can you get started? Maybe you're worried about starting going to the gym or losing some weight or trying to run a marathon or something physical. Well, maybe this video can help you just get started. It's that first step. All you need to do is that first step. Tony Robbins said it really well at the fire walk at Unleash the Power. Once you take that first step onto the coals, you will take the second, third, fourth, and fifth, and you'll finish. It's that only that first step that you need to take to get started. And so this video is encouraging you to take that first step in a safe, controlled environment so that you're safe and healthy and sound, but you also start to grow and you start to stretch and you start to take some risks that you weren't comfortable taking. And you'll soon find that as you take more gradual, small steps of risk, you get comfortable taking more steps and larger steps and more risk, and embracing that risk can be a really powerful tool in generating wealth, because most people fear risk and therefore they pay to get rid of risk. And if you get comfortable taking risk and accepting risk and getting paid to take risk, you're in a winning position. But in a nutshell, the conclusion is, I am so grateful for my guide Kai and Exum for helping me up there. I'm so grateful for my friend for inviting me and helping me stretch and grow. You are a byproduct of the people that you surround yourself with. You will find yourself stretching and growing if you surround yourself with mentors, guides, experts, people that have done what it is that you want to do. And again, this wasn't something that I wanted to do, but I am so grateful that I've done it. It's been so meaningful to me, and I'm not sure that I'll ever do it again, right? Like, this isn't a conversion story and now I'm a rock climber. I still think it's crazy, and I think it's crazy that I did it, but I'm so grateful that I did it. And it's a feel-good story. It's a story about strength. It's an inspiring story. It's a motivating story. I've learned so much about myself, my physicality, how strong I am mentally. And now I know unequivocally I can show up. When my back's up against the wall, I can show up and I can do anything, whether I've done it before or not. And just imagine how strong and empowering that is, going through life knowing that you can show up and perform when the times get tough. You show up, you give it your all, you win, you succeed, and you just summit Mount Moran, 12,700 feet. Took me 2 days, never done it before, and just gave it my all. I left it out there. I went home. Erica took great care of me, had a massage the next day, and life is fantastic. So I'd love to hear your comments below. What have you done that's pushing you outside of the limit? What are you doing to take more risks? How are you growing? How are you stretching? Who are your experts? Leave the comments below. And I hope you found this video inspirational, motivating, educational, and something that you're going to think about as you grow and stretch yourself to perform. Now is the time, friends. Let's do this. Like the video and subscribe to the channel. Yes!